this is Bhuneshwari from Department of Computer Science. In today's class, I am going to discuss the following topics: Adobe Photoshop at a glance, getting started, genesis of Photoshop, tools description, and some exercises. Adobe Photoshop at a glance. This is the PC view of Adobe Photoshop. In the top, we can able to see the menu bar. Some menus are File, Edit, Image, Layer, Select, Filter, Analysis, View, Window, etc. In the side, we can able to see the toolbox. Some important tools are Move, Lasso, Crop, Brush Tool, Stamp, Eraser Tool, Gradient, Blur, Dodge, Hand, Text, etc. In the top left, color and swatch panel is available. It is used to select the colors and swatches. You can also able to apply styles using this panel. In the bottom, layers and channels panel is available. First layer is always a background layer. All other layers are on the top of the background layer. This is the online view of Photoshop. The options will be same as the one available in PC. Introduction to Photoshop. It is a standard tool for graphics, image processing, and image manipulation. This tool was released by Adobe. It is useful for both creating and editing images to be used in print or online. These are the different versions of Photoshop, but here we are going to study in detail about version 12, which is CS5. Some of the uses of Photoshop. It is used in image editing, graphic designing, used to create animated images, for example GIF, used to create logos. It is used to create passport sized photos. It is used in businesses like color studios, color labs, etc. Getting started. How to open a new Photoshop document in PC or laptop. Go to Start button, click All Apps, select Adobe Photoshop CS5 based on the operating system. 64-bit or 32-bit. Go to File, New, Set, Width, Height, Resolution, Color Mode, and Background. In the new dialog box, give the name as Exercise 1. You can give any name. Width as 1200, Height 800, Resolution 1000, Color Mode RGB, Background White, and click OK. How to do Photoshop online? For that, open the URL www.freeonlinephotoshop.com. Go to File, select New, give name, any name, set with height and background, click OK. We are going to see toolbox in detail. Tools are organized in the following groups: View, Select, Enhance, Draw, Modify. First, we are going to see View tools. Zoom is one of the View tools. It is used to zoom the image in or out. For example, zoom in or zoom out. Zoom in tool. It is used to make the image much larger and nearer. Using this tool, we can able to see the portion of the boat much closer, like the one given in the figure. Zoom out tool. It is used to make the image much smaller and further away. Using this tool, we can reduce the size of the image to smaller. Hand tool. It is used to move the photo in the Photoshop workspace. Using hand tool, we can able to move the image anywhere in the workspace when it is in zoom mode. Now we are going to see draw tools. In that, we are going to see brush tool. It is used to create soft or hard strokes of color. The example is given in the figure. Next tool is color replacement tool. It is used to replace specific colors in your image. Say for example, in the image given, the flower is white in color. After applying this tool, the color has been changed to orange. Likewise, the background color is green before applying this tool. After applying this tool, we can able to change the color from green to blue. Next one is pencil tool. It is used to create freehand lines. It is similar to the one in MS Paint. The example is given in the figure. Next one is eraser tool. This tool is used to erase the pixels in the image. In the figure, we can able to see eraser tool is used to remove unwanted portions in the image. Next one is background eraser tool. It is used to turn the color pixels to transparent pixels so that you can easily remove an object from its background. In the figure, we have removed the person walking in the street by applying this tool. Next one is magic eraser. Magic eraser tool is used to change all the similar pixels with a single click. In this figure, we have removed the white pixels from the given image. Next one is paint bucket tool. It is used to fill areas of image with solid colors. Here in this example, we have filled the circles with different colors like red, yellow, blue, orange, and green. Next we are going to see custom shape tool. Using this tool, we can create different shapes like rectangle, rounded rectangle, ellipse, polygon, line, custom shape also. Next tool is gradient tool. It is used to fill the area of image by a gradient. It will create a gradual mix of multiple colors. Various options available in gradient tool are shown in the figure. Next one is color picker tool. This tool is used to copy or sample the color of an area in the photograph to set a new background or foreground. Next one is type tool. It is used to create and edit text on your image. Other type related tools available are horizontal type tool, vertical type tool, horizontal type mask tool, vertical type mask tool. Horizontal type mask tool. It is used to create a selection in the shape of a text. You can cut the text out of an image and paste it in a new image. The example is given in the figure. Next one is vertical type mask tool. It works similar to horizontal type mask tool, but the selection is done vertically. Example is given in the figure. Next we are going to see enhanced tools. Eye tool is one of the enhanced tools. It is used to remove red eye effect, pet eye effect, and correct closed eyes in photographs. In the figure, after applying this tool, red eyes of child becomes normalized. Likewise, using this tool, we can remove red eyes of pet animals also. Next one is blur tool. It is used to soften hard edges or areas in an image by reducing its details. Before applying these tools, the background is clearly visible. After applying this tool, we can able to see the difference, that is, the background becomes blur. Next one is spot healing brush. This tool is used to remove spots from your photographs. In this figure, the spots in child's face has been removed using this tool. Next one is sharpen tool. Sharpen tool is used to sharpen a photo by focusing soft edges in the photo to increase its clarity or focus. The top is an original image. Bottom right shows the two faces are over sharpened, and bottom left shows the two faces are sharpened correctly. Next one is modify tool. In that we are going to see crop tool. It is used to crop or clip an image in a customized way. The example is given in the figure. Next tool is slice tool. It is used to select a square or rectangular area that you want to preserve, which can then be saved as a new Photoshop document. Next is slice select tool. It is used to select, move and resize slices. How to apply slice tool? In this example, we are going to slice the tree from the given image, and we are going to save the tree image as a separate document. I am going to teach how to work with images. For that, go to file, open a new image from your device. I am going to select this image. Then select the horizontal type tool and type the text, happy morning. And increase the point size to some 100. You can able to see the change in the font size. Again, I'm going to change the font size. I'm going to change it as 200. Click the tick symbol. You can able to move the text using move tool. Again, I am going to select horizontal type tool. I'm going to type the text, have a nice day. Change the font to Times New Roman. And click the tick symbol. And I am going to change the font style. For that, go to styles and select any one of the style. The style name is Nebula. You can select any one of the styles. I'm going to change the style as blue glass. You can able to see the difference. Now I am going to change the style of happy morning. I'm going to use the style puzzle. This is how you can work with images. How to create custom shapes? For that, go to File, click New. In the New dialog box, give the name as Shapes. Width as 1200, height 800, resolution 1000, and color mode RGB color, and click OK. New Photoshop document will get opened. Then go to Shape tool, select Custom Shape tool, and see the shapes in the option bar. First select stars symbol. I'm going to draw the star and now the color of the star is red. I'm going to change the color to yellow. Select yellow color and click OK. Next, again go to Shapes. Select some other shapes like butterfly. I'm going to select butterfly. And going to change the color of butterfly to purple. Now I'm going to draw the next shape. I'm going to select leaf. And going to change the color of leaf to green. Click OK. Next, again I'm going to select some other shape. I'm going to select pin symbol. And I'm going to change the color of pin symbol as blue color. Next, I'm going to draw heart symbol. As we know that heart symbol is a red in color, I'm going to change the color is red. Next, I'm going to select the next symbol. Recycle symbol. Going to change the color as green. Click OK. Next, I'm going to select the next symbol, globe. going to change the color as black color. Now click OK. This is how you have to draw custom shapes.